Hi folks, I'm Will Dinius, a content developer and technical trainer at MinIO. Today I'm going to be taking you through a short form course that's going to give you a little introduction to using MinIO as the backend for H2O and R for developing machine learning applications. We're going to be using the RStudio IDE, which is a very powerful tool that allows us to bring all of this stuff together. And you're going to see just how simple it is to use MinIO as your data layer for just such an application. I've been delivering technical training for developers for about 20 years now, starting with Java, and I'm really excited on where machine learning and AI is headed. This short form course is based on a blog post by Brian Costa, and we'll be giving you a link to that in just a second. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump in and see what we're going to do with this. This short form course is all about machine learning using H2O, R, and MinIO. What we're going to show you in this course is really how MinIO can be used as the data layer for all of your machine learning tools. In this case, we're using H2O and R. Both of those connect very easily with S3, and since MinIO is an S3 compatible data layer, it makes it very easy for us to use MinIO as a drop-in replacement for that. This course is actually based on a blog by Brian Costa, who is our lead on all things machine learning and artificial intelligence here at MinIO. And he has written a blog on how to do this as well. I highly recommend reading his blog. It goes into a lot more detail on how H2O and R work. And what we're really focused on here is how you can use MinIO rather than H2O and R in particular. One of the biggest things that machine learning requires is lots of data. You're going to be getting this data from a variety of sources, but you need so much data that you're going to have a way to store it. And that storage layer needs to be scalable because you're going to grow that data very quickly over time. So having MinIO as your data layer means that you can scale this up from a local system to a cluster, even to the cloud very simply, and you won't have to change all of your code to do it. And of course, as you're processing the data and you're creating models for your machine learning and all that other stuff, guess what? That's even more data that you're going to have to store somewhere. And again, MinIO comes into the rescue and allows you to store all that data very easily. By using MinIO for all of the data, you can have all of your applications generating logs or metrics. All of that can be sent into a particular bucket that your application can then access. The application formatting the data could use another bucket. Maybe it pulls the data from that logs, from that raw location, does some pre-processing, puts it in another bucket. And then, of course, your machine learning tools can output their models to yet another bucket. And that makes it very simple for you to have all of these different locations for all of your data. Now that may seem like it's a little complicated, and of course you as an application developer are probably not going to be required to maintain all of those buckets. But you can actually, if you don't want to use buckets, you can actually just separate stuff out with prefixes, of course. There is a bit of a trade-off there, although it's completely up to you which one you want to use. By using different buckets, it makes separating the data between tiers or clusters very simple. You just move the bucket to a new cluster or whatever you need to do, and then separately, your different buckets will also allow you to have different policies for retention and versioning and so on and so forth. You may want to have extensive versioning on your models, but you may not need versioning on your log data coming in. Log data really gets written once, it never gets updated, so there's no need to have a version on that. And of course, retention, you may need to retain your logs for a lot longer than you retain your models. So having these different buckets that have different policies or maybe have different lifecycle management policies, that's a good way to go. But again, prefixes in a single bucket helps you keep all the data in one place, so you're not looking around for all of your data. But again, it's up to you. I actually like having separate buckets for this. And in our example that you're going to see, I actually have two separate buckets. So connecting all of this stuff up to MinIO, you're probably thinking, oh, wow, I got to learn all this connection stuff. Well, guess what? MinIO is S3 compatible, which means that if your tools work with S3, they work with MinIO. It's really just a drop-in replacement. In the examples you're going to see using R and using H2O to connect to MinIO, I'm really just using the S3 libraries that are provided for those tools. I'm not using a specific MinIO library for this. H2O works very well with MinIO. It's very easy to connect your H2O system to load data and to write data. And R has libraries for working with MinIO and H2O because R has libraries for working with S3 and H2O. So what we're going to see is when we start building all this stuff out, it's really a very basic process to getting all this connected. So let's go ahead and jump into a practical example here. We're going to take some sample data stored in MinIO, and then we're going to train a model in H2O using AutoML, and to link all that stuff together to make it easily repeatable, we're going to use R to do some processing. The RStudio IDE is a very powerful tool. It has a terminal in it. It's very easy to run line by line your code, or you can even run your code as one big application. And then you can also manage all of your data, all of your files, all of your different bits and pieces very easily in RStudio as well. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into our example.